Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. In this video tutorial, I will show you how you can set up configuration settings in your Xcode project. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, let me just show you what we are going to build out today, and it will be real easy to do. So let's say you have some constants in your app, like some IDs or anything like that, and you want to store them not inside your Swift files, but in a neat plist file. So here I have a dictionary called mydict, and it has a number with a key value, a key called version and the value of 5. And inside this root folder, I also have a so-called naked key pair with the key of language and the type of string and the value of Swift. So I would like to access all of these throughout my code. And I do access it inside my root view controller here. And it's pretty simple. It's config values.get.language, and that would be, of course, Swift. And with the same old dot syntax, I just grab my version here with my dict dot version. Of course, you will learn how to set this config values.get up in this video. So let's just build and run this and see what do we get in the console. Okay, there it is. Language is Swift 5.0. Okay, let's just stop this and start off with a brand new project. There we go. And I will use my single view application template. Go ahead and click the link down below for details on how you can do that. Basically, it removes the main.storyboard. And we do all of our coding in code. Well, coding in code, yes, without storyboards. Okay, so I will name this, config Swift. Okay, that's right. It will have Swift language and embedded in navigation control. It doesn't really matter. I'm just printing out something in the log right now. So let me create a new folder here real quick with the code. And I will create a Git repository on my Mac and I will upload it to my GitHub repositories so you can take a look at it later on. Okay, let's create it here. And let me just resize this so you can see it better. There we go. Now, you will see in the description a link with where you can join Rebeloper.com and you can get all of my resources. And in the resources, you will find a config.swift file. Now, I'm just going to drag and drop this here because it's much simpler and I will just explain what the code looks like. And this will remain all the same throughout your code base. So this is our config value struct, and it has this static function called get. It returns a config, and that is a decodable. Now, I won't go into details why this needs to be a decodable. Just make sure that under for resource, you have this config string, and that is exactly the name of your plist file. So let's go ahead and create it. Hit command N and new file template chooser will pop up. I will choose, let's just scroll all the way down till we see our plist file. Where is it? I missed that. Oh, here it is, property list. And let's click on next there. So let's name this config, but you can name it whatever you want as long as you just set that here. So config and config. Okay, so let's start off by adding our language. Okay, so what you want to do is click on this plus button and call this language. There we go. And it will be a string. Now you have a lot of options: array, dictionary, boolean, date, date, number, string. You can choose any of these. For now, I just choose string because Swift is a string. I just want to have this. Okay, now let's go back into config, and it says here under config struct that add keys here. So let's add them here. Let's see. Let language, and make sure that this is the same as the key that you set in the plist file. And that will be of type string. Yep, let's hit command B, so everything should compile. And yeah, let's go back to our root view controller, and here let's just print out our language. So print language is, and now we just simply get that with config values dot get. So we are getting all of our plist here, and then with the dot notation we get our language. And yeah, let's just build and run and see. Oh, not on my phone. Let's select a simulator here, and we will see that we will get this language is Swift in the console. Let's just wait for that, and there we go. Language is Swift. Now, if you recall in the example, we don't want to add everything in the root because maybe we will have a few tens of keys here, and yeah, we want to have dictionaries. So let's add in here, let's say my dictionary, and select a dictionary here, and open it and click on this plus button again, and let's add in here version. Okay, and this will be a number, and the version will be 5. Okay, and that is basically what you want to do in your plist file. Now let's go back to our config, and what you might want to do right off the bat is add in here like let my dict, and that will be a dictionary, but that will not work basically. So let me just uncomment this. You need to create a struct called my dict, and that confirms to the decodable. So let's see here, struct my dict, and that conforms to the decodable protocol. And here we just add in some new values like version, and that will be now, if you see, we have a number here. Now when it decodes it, you can add anything here, like integers, doubles, CG floats. So I will add in here a CG float just for example. Of course, you basically cannot add in here 5.1, but yeah, that is one drawback, but you could, let's say, come around with a nice hack for that. Okay, here we have our version. Now we need to declare it in the config decodable, or in the struct, and that is of course of type not dictionary but my dict. And yeah, that is all you have to do. Let me just go to our root view controller, and let's just add in here config values dot get. And now I type in here, let's hit command B so we get the auto completion from Xcode, my dict and version. There we go, pretty simple. Hit command R, and now we will see that we have language is Swift 5.0. Now that is because we have unwrapped it inside a CG float. And if we would, let's say, add in here, let's see, int, then we would have just Swift 5, but most probably you will use CG floats or maybe doubles. So yeah, 5. Let me just make that back to CG float. Now that is it for this really easy configuration of constant values in your Xcode project. Of course, all of this in Swift 5. Now how amazing is that? If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell, because even if you subscribe, you may not get the latest videos on your feed. So hit that notification bell, I dare you. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.